It's a fascinating time in the environmental fluids lab.
It's exciting and it's interesting and it's very different than what most people think of when they think of marine science.
Faculty and students at Coastal Carolina University are involved in research regarding the way sharks move through the water. The effort will involve creating a model and testing it in the flume.
We're going to try and get the model to move and feel exactly like a normal shark.
Findings could have real-world applications.
The point of all this research is to better understand how different bodies move through the water so efficiently. If we can understand what these organisms are doing, then we can design better underwater vehicles.
Part of the research concerns lemon sharks, which cover large distances and have two dorsal fins of similar size.
We're trying to figure out if there's any kind of purpose to this feature, or is it some kind of dying evolutionary trait?
The model will attempt to replicate a mako shark, the fastest of the shark species.
This shark only oscillates its tail, so it makes it easier to emulate and also has the fast swimming capabilities that we're looking for.
Mako sharks can't be kept in captivity and are difficult to work with in the wild.
The fact that we can scale it down and model what is going on in the wild here in the lab, I think is ingenious.
A motor is being created to move the tail of the model. Silicone has been combined with different concentrations of paint thinner in an attempt to mimic a shark's flexibility. Those different polymers were recently compared to a sample of shark tissue.
We're testing to see what material is most like a shark.
Testing was done in a lab at Ori Georgetown Technical College, a lab typically used to test building materials.
Have never tested a shark before. This is the first time testing flesh of any kind.
These deformation tests were intended to show which polymer was most similar to the shark tissue.
I think they had a positive feeling going back to their own lab and doing some analysis that they're going to find results that they can use.
It's definitely getting us one step closer to having our actual moving modeled sharks.
A lot of elements have to come together to produce a model that will serve as a suitable substitute for a shark in the tests to come.
I think we've made a lot of progress so far. Obviously, we have to wait to see to get a definite answer.
Ultimately, the model will be placed into the flume in the fluids lab, and hydrodynamic data will be generated.
Getting close to the finish line and being able to see it actually up and running would be very rewarding.
It's only because of the facilities at Coastal that this work is possible.
Without the tank, we wouldn't be able to carry out these experiments or really do this research in any way.
Tim Hesford chose to spend the summer here, devoting his time to this research.
I feel like it's definitely distinctive being here, though, at Coastal and working with such a cool program.
This is the kind of work that prepares students for life after college.
Anytime a student is involved in research is a really valuable experience.
This particular research is especially helpful.
I can take what I'm learning here and apply it not just to the biological side, but many different aspects of shark research.
It combines biology, physics, engineering, all sorts of disciplines.
So learning basically a variety of different skill sets, which is essentially, I think, making me more marketable in the field.
The hope is a model will be ready to go into the flume by the end of summer.